This, my friends, is the story of a little glowworm named Elsie. I thought you ought to know about Elsie, although Elsie was only a glowworm, nothing more and nothing less. But, and it pains me to say it, Elsie was just a little bit screwy. While all the other lady glowworms were sitting at home making a plan for a man, Elsie was out making passes at the masses. Every evening she would wriggle her little body to the top of an anthill and just sit there glowing like crazy. First she'd glow pink, then she'd glow yellow, then green, then mauve. And on the 4th of July, she'd just knock herself out glowing red, white, and blue. Well, one day, along came a long, fuzzy caterpillar, and he saw Elsie glowing. My, but he was a handsome thing. Long, green, and fuzzy. And when he saw Elsie, he stopped. And his little heart went pitty-pat, 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 pitty-pat. Oh, it was love at first sight. And it isn't odd, you know, for a caterpillar to fall in love with a worm. For what is a caterpillar, after all, but a worm with upholstery? And so they were quietly married and made themselves a nice little apartment in the toe of an old rubber boot. And they were very happy. Every night, Elsie would sit in front of her dressing table and glow green, red, and purple all over. At times, she would even glow polka dot. And her husband loved her for it. But one day, the inevitable happened. A little girl walked by their home wearing a plaid dress. Now, Elsie had never seen plaid before, and it gave her ideas. She didn't glow for days after that. She just sat quietly at home, eating her head off and building up strength. And when she felt strong enough, she called her husband to her side and she said, "Roger, Roger, tonight I am going to outdo myself. Tonight I am going to glow plaid." And she huffed and she puffed and she glowed and she blew out a fuse. Poor Elsie had overdone herself. And when the doctor came, he said, "Elsie, Elsie, if you want to go on living, you must never glow again. Use that posterior lamppost of yours just once more, and you'll be delighted. No end." Well, a tear came to Elsie's eye, and she looked at the doctor, and she looked at her husband, and she glowed. And as she lay there dying, her poor, heartbroken husband said, "Elsie, oh, Elsie, why did you do it? Why did you glow when the doctor told you not to?" And Elsie looked him proudly in the eye and said, "You forget, Roger, that I am an artist. And when I got a glow, I got a glow."